Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common Toyota 2GR-FE engine problems. The Toyota 2GR engine began production in 2005 and still remains in production to this very day. It's found in dozens of different Toyota, Lexus, and even Lotus models. So the 2GR-FE is a very popular Toyota engine. It is also very reliable and a very stout engine, which is in part why it has lived on for almost two decades at this point and has been found in so many different vehicles, is because the 2GR has really been a very successful engine for Toyota. So just want to put that out there up front, that while we're discussing the most common problems in this video, it doesn't necessarily mean that they're actually common problems. Instead, when issues pop up, these are a couple areas to be on the lookout for. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss a few of the most common problems with the Toyota 2GR-FE. Number one on the list, we have VVTi oil leaks, so the variable valve timing system. Now, Toyota had used a rubber hose on early 2GR engines to feed the VVT-i system, and ultimately that rubber hose would simply degrade and wear down with age and mileage and became a common issue. However, this really only affects early model 2GR-FE engines, as Toyota did update and redesign the oil line, so it is an all-metal design from 2010 up. One thing to talk about with the VVT-i oil leaks, and rather oil leaks in general, is this was one of those common problems that plagued earlier models. Toyota addressed that. However, oil leaks can still be a common problem, not just on the 2GR-FE, but this can be said about any engine in general. Again, this thing has been around for nearly two decades now, dating back to 2005. And all cars and engines are prone to oil leaks as they age. Simple things like plastic components or rubber-like components like seals, gaskets, hoses, O-rings, etc., simply degrade and wear down with age and mileage. So that's something to keep in mind with the 2GR-FE. That's not anything related to any true design flaws or issues with the engine. Instead, just the nature of owning an older engine. So if you are looking to pick up one of these older 2GR engines, just something to keep in mind that while they are still incredibly reliable engines to this day, an older engine is just naturally going to require a little bit of TLC and have a couple extra problems pop up here and there. Moving on to our second most common problem, we have issues with the idler pulley. As with the VVT-i oil leaks, this is another problem that really only affected and plagued earlier 2GR engines, which it makes sense. Engines early on in their design and life cycle tend to have a couple minor design flaws and issues, but the good news with the 2GR is Toyota addressed all of these very quickly, so the idler pulley is something that, again, is only going to affect those earlier 2005 until 2009 models. Around 2010, Toyota updated the idler pulley to a much heavier duty version that hasn't shown to have any common issues with that updated idler pulley design. So again, really something that isn't fair to hold against the 2GR. It's natural for any engine to have a couple problems and a couple kinks to work out early in its life cycle. Have to give props to Toyota for quickly recognizing these issues and addressing them for the longer term. As one final comment to note, this isn't really a severe issue that's going to cause any reliability or longevity concerns. Instead, when the idler pulley goes bad, it tends to just make a rather obnoxious noise, and so that could be frustrating if you run into that, but ultimately, again, not something that's super urgent and needs to be repaired immediately. So in the grand scheme, this is a relatively minor issue, and most of these earlier models that had one of the older outdated parts have likely failed by now. So hopefully most of the 2005 to 2009 models that had this issue have had them replaced. So if you're looking to pick one up now, just keep in mind that that is something to potentially be on the lookout for. Moving on to our third and final common problem, we have water pump failure. Again, props to Toyota. I don't mean to sound like a broken record here, but the water pump failures are very much like the first two issues that we discussed, in that water pump failures primarily plagued early 2005 to 2008 models. Sometime in 2009, Toyota had updated the water pump design. So really a very minor issue, again, in the grand scheme, only affected a few of those earlier years and models before Toyota quickly addressed and remedied those issues. This is a wear and tear component, and water pumps are a common problem on a lot of different engines as they get older and higher mileage. So very much like with the oil leaks I discussed, even if the water pump doesn't fail due to it being an earlier original design, there still are natural wear and tear failures that occur with these water pumps on the 2GR engines. So something else to be on the lookout for if you are in the market for an older, say 10, 12, 15 year old 2GR-FE engine, that a lot of the times that kind of age can be past the typical or normal lifespan of any water pump. Not a design flaw there, just something to keep in mind with some of these older 2GR-FE engines out there. So that really wraps up all of the common problems for the Toyota 2GR engine. And I put common problems in quotations for good reason. None of these were truly common problems that affected a large percentage of these 2GR engines. Instead, when issues do pop up or when issues did arise in the past, these were a few of the most common areas for failures and issues. Ultimately, the 2GR is an incredibly reliable engine overall. Toyota did an excellent job at identifying any issues early on in the engine's life cycle and making the necessary changes and adjustments to make these engines much more reliable for the longer term. And that really shows in the fact that Toyota has trusted this engine in so many different models and vehicles over its nearly two decade lifespan. And the fact that it's still in production today shows that this really has been a very successful, very reliable engine for Toyota. So really nothing bad to say about it. The few common problems aren't even major issues in the grand scheme. No engine is perfect. Every engine is going to be prone to a couple issues here and there, but the 2GR-FE is certainly up there with some of the most reliable gasoline engines of all time. So again, nothing but good remarks and good things to say for this engine. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. Thanks, everyone.